As the 1990s came to a close, the newly established Russian Federation faced the dual challenge of modernizing its aging military while recovering from the economic turmoil caused by the collapse of the Soviet Union. These circumstances created a pressing need to develop new vehicles capable of fulfilling specialized combat roles at minimal cost. One such requirement was for a heavily armored personnel carrier to transport specialized flamethrower troops on the battlefield. Given budget constraints, designing a new vehicle from scratch was not feasible. Instead, a solution was found in redesigning an already existing vehicle to fit this special role. A main battle tank, for instance, could be repurposed to become an armored personnel carrier fit for transporting troops while offering a decent amount of protection. And what better tank to choose for this endeavor than the iconic T-72? Over the decade following the end of the Second World War, Soviet tank development led to the creation of a series of MBTs that saw widespread use across the globe. In the early 1970s, a new tank, designated the T-72, entered service. This model was developed as a more affordable and less complex alternative to the costly T-64. Due to its lower production costs, approximately 18,000 T-72s were manufactured. Its robust and cost-efficient design allowed the T-72 to see combat across multiple conflicts, from the late Cold War era to 21st century warfare, outlasting the Soviet Union itself and cementing its place in the history of armored vehicles as one of the most prolific and effective MBTs. Despite its age, the modernized T-72 remains the backbone of the Russian army in the 2020s. However, after nearly 50 years in service and despite numerous upgrades, the T-72 is reaching the limits of its development. Given the significant investment in these tanks and how common they are in the Russian arsenal, simply discarding them is often not an option. Even the worn-out and out-of-service tanks are frequently stored in reserve for extended periods until their repair and reactivation are required. Even this approach is far from ideal, so attempts have been made to repurpose these tanks for various other projects. For example, Russia has been experimenting with converting older tank chassis into APCs. While transforming a tank into an APC is no simple task, it is an appealing option as it can massively reduce development time and costs. The usual method for the aforementioned conversion is to remove the tank's turret and replace it with a new large superstructure on top of the chassis, which would contain the infantry dismounts and their gear, complete with additional rear or top hatches for them to mount/dismount from the vehicle. A smaller turret can be installed to house a light defensive weapon, such as a heavy machine gun or an autocannon. As a final touch, you could throw on some explosive reactive armor for added protection. Thus, an aging tank may get its service life prolonged by being converted to serve a different role on a modern battlefield, that of an armored personnel carrier. The first such attempt was the BTRT, Armored Personnel Carrier Heavy, which aimed to repurpose the vast Russian stockpiles of T-54 and T-55 tanks. By removing the turret, reinforcing the chassis, and raising the height of the vehicle, the tank could be converted into a cost-effective yet moderately well-protected APC. However, several design flaws, including limited troop capacity, a cramped interior, and Russian financial hardships, led to the project being rejected for mass production. In the early 2000s, the BMO-T Flamethrower Combat Vehicle Heavy project was initiated. Despite its name, the vehicle was not designed for troops using traditional flamethrowers, but rather for those employing rocket-assisted thermobaric warheads. These weapons have a relatively short range, requiring the units that operate them to engage at close distances. As a result, a heavily protected vehicle became essential to enhance their effectiveness and ensure their safety during operations. For the BMO-T project, a modified T-72B chassis was used. The vehicle retained individual torsion bar suspension and shock absorbers, but the fuel tanks were relocated to the upper sides of the vehicle, positioned between the crew compartment and the side armor. It is powered by an 84-horsepower V84M 4-stroke V-shaped 12-cylinder multi-fuel liquid-cooled diesel engine. Its transmission includes 7 forward gears and 1 reverse gear, allowing the BMO-T to achieve speeds of up to 60 km per hour, or 37 miles per hour, on paved roads, and 40 km per hour, or 25 miles per hour, on rough terrain. The new superstructure features an angled front, while the sides and rear are flat. At the front, ERA plates, a sliding driver's hatch with a single periscope positioned just beneath it, and a total of 12 smoke grenade launchers are placed. On top of the superstructure sits a small commander's cupola, similar in design to that of the T-72. This spring-loaded cupola is fully rotatable and provides a 288-degree field of view through 5 periscopes. These include the TKN-3MK day-night binocular periscope, which offers both passive and active night vision capabilities and is mounted at the front of the cupola, along with 2 TNPA-65A periscopes and 2 TNPO-160 periscopes. Additionally, the entire cupola can rotate independently, allowing the NSVT machine gun mount to achieve a full 360-degree field of fire without the need to traverse both the cupola and the gun. 2 additional hatches are incorporated to serve as firing positions for the passengers, allowing them to engage targets from within the vehicle. To enhance situational awareness, 5 vision devices are installed on each side of the roof, giving the passengers a broader field of view. Moving from the roof towards the rear of the vehicle, armored hatches can be found on the back section. These hatches swing upward to facilitate the easy mounting and dismounting of infantry. Each hatch is also equipped with a periscope to further assist passengers during deployment. Toward the rear of the vehicle, additional stowage was incorporated in the form of multiple bins mounted on either side of the chassis. These bins not only provided extra storage, but also offered partial cover for the dismounting infantry. Since the BMO-T retained the T-72's original engine compartment, soldiers had to climb down from the engine deck when exiting the vehicle. To ease this process, a spring-loaded pedestal was installed at the rear, allowing for slightly easier access for both mounting and dismounting. The designers aimed to enhance the protection of the aging T-72B chassis to meet the new standards of the early 2000s. The front of the vehicle was thus equipped with contact 5 ERA blocks for added protection, while the sides were reinforced with additional layers of varied armor. The BMOT's armament consists of a single NSVT 12.7mm heavy machine gun, a reliable weapon effective against both infantry and lightly armored vehicles due to its ability to fire armor-piercing and fragmentation rounds. The vehicle's commander operates the machine gun by opening the cupola hatch and standing on the edge of his seat to reach the controls. The gun mount offers a wide range of elevation, from negative 5 degrees to positive 75 degrees, making it versatile for different targets. It's also equipped with the K-10T reflector sight, aiding in the engagement of low-flying aircraft. While the gun can be rotated independently of the commander's cupola, the traverse mechanism is manual, which can make aiming more difficult, especially when the vehicle is positioned on uneven terrain. Originally, the BMOT was intended to feature remote controls for operating the machine gun from within the vehicle, but this idea was abandoned in the production models, likely due to budget limitations. The passengers were armed with RPO, rocket-propelled infantry flamethrower, a man-portable single-use weapon designed to neutralize enemy structures and entrenched infantry through thermobaric or aerosol explosions. Developed in the 1970s to replace conventional flamethrowers, the RPO was a lighter, safer, and more effective method of delivering destructive firepower to enemy positions. Thermobaric weapons function by harnessing the devastating effects of fuel combustion and air pressure. Upon impact, the RPO disperses a cloud of flammable aerosol, which rapidly spreads over a wide area. A secondary charge then ignites the aerosol, producing a large fireball that incinerates anything within the blast radius. The rapid combustion also causes surrounding air to rush into the blast zone, creating a powerful shockwave capable of destroying entire buildings. The first RPO was deployed in Afghanistan by Soviet flamethrower infantry, though its performance was found lacking. Consequently, the development of the RPO-A began in the late 1970s and was finalized with its introduction to Soviet troops in 1988. The RPO-A was lighter, more compact, and significantly more effective than its predecessor, earning a better reputation among soldiers, particularly during the Chechen Wars of 1995 and 2001. The RPO-A rockets are stored horizontally in 3 protective racks, each holding 10 rockets, for a total of 30 rockets. Due to the rocket's backblast and the absence of firing ports, firing the RPO from inside the BMO-T is not possible. Instead, flamethrower troops must either fully dismount or partially expose themselves by using the upper hatches to engage targets with their RPO rockets. The BMO-T, while an interesting design, is far from perfect. One significant drawback was the placement of the engine compartment, which remained the same as in the T-72B. This meant that infantry passengers had to climb over the engine block and pass through a set of armored hatches at the rear of the passenger compartment to mount or dismount the vehicle. This method was not only uncomfortable, as soldiers had to navigate the engine area each time they entered or exited, but it also exposed them to enemy fire while they moved across the top of the vehicle. Although additional steel storage boxes on either side of the engine provided some protection, it was insufficient, particularly given the vehicle's role as a heavy armored personnel carrier designed to bring assault infantry as close to enemy lines as possible. The vehicle's primary armament is also relatively weak for its size, effective only against infantry and lightly armored targets. Another issue is the commander's lack of remote control for his HMG, forcing him to leave his protected station by opening his hatch and standing up, half exposed, to operate the NSVT. Given that the BMO-T was developed around the same time as the BTRT, it's important to consider why the former was accepted into service while the latter was rejected. Although there isn't a clear-cut answer, several factors likely influenced this outcome. The BMO-T is based on a newer chassis and offers a larger transport capacity, accommodating 7 dismounts in addition to its 2 crew members. Moreover, the BMO-T was developed as a more specialized vehicle, specifically for flamethrower units, giving it a niche role that the BTRT lacked. Despite this, only a small number of BMO-Ts, estimated at 10 to 15 vehicles, were converted and entered into active service with the Russian Army. For a long time, the BMO-T stayed out of the limelight and was not documented taking part in any of the conflicts. However, this changed with the beginning of the Russian invasion of Ukraine in 2022, marking its first major public deployment. So far, at least 3 BMO-T vehicles have been confirmed destroyed, supported by video and photographic evidence. The first was reported destroyed on the 12th of April 2022 in the Cherniv area. The second on the 11th of August 2022 in an undisclosed location in Ukraine, and the third on the 14th of September 2022 in the Kharkiv region. While details about the circumstances of their destruction remain sparse, it is difficult to assess the effectiveness of the vehicle's protection and performance without a more comprehensive post-conflict evaluation. Additionally, a photograph surfaced on the 18th of June 2023 showing a captured BMO-T being integrated into Ukrainian service. It remains unclear whether this vehicle is a restored version of one of those destroyed in 2022 or a newly captured BMO-T from the ongoing Ukrainian counteroffensive that began earlier that month. On the 21st of July 2023, a video was uploaded showing a BMO-T being put into Ukrainian service, towed by a tank. Again, it is uncertain whether this is the same BMO-T captured in June or another newly acquired vehicle. This concludes our video on the Russian BMO-T. What do you think about this unusual, heavily armored flamethrower personnel carrier? Would the concept have more merit if the flaws are ironed out? Share your opinions in the comments below. If you haven't done so already, we invite you to subscribe to stay updated on future content. If you'd like to contribute further, consider supporting us on Patreon or PayPal. We want to especially thank our medium and heavy tank Patreon supporters, Alex Harvey, Andrew Oberg, Dan Fitzpatrick, Dave Schuford, Gustavo Sanchez, Joe, Leslie Holkower, Owen M., Peter Bradbury, The Sasquatch, and Why Do You Care? Your generous contributions help fund our research, illustrations, and video production. Until next time, keep us in your sights.